Making news tonight, filled with fury, protesters have today taken to the streets in honour of a murdered woman whose stalker, they say, got off too lightly.
Fighting for justice.
Justice for Celeste! Keep going!
On November 16, 2020, 23-year-old Celeste Manno was murdered in her bed, stabbed 23 times by Lue Seiko, a former co-worker turned obsessive stalker. It took him just 2 minutes and 39 seconds to kill her.
Sweetie, I said I'd never give up and I'll continue to fight.
Today, Celeste's mum, Aggie, demanded an appeal that Seiko, sentenced to 36 years in prison, should instead be jailed for life.
What happened to Celeste could have happened and could happen to anyone.
They could attack you anytime, anywhere, and you'd never know how. What happened to Celeste could have happened to me.
This week, Di McDonald launched Stalking Awareness Day to help victims get support. Di was stalked for 3 years by a man she'd met through work. He was sentenced to 8 months jail, released after just six.
You've got no idea how angry I was and also how helpless.
Di now wears a security device to alert friends and family to call the police if she feels unsafe.
It is disappointing that I have to arm myself with electronic monitoring and that the offender is allowed to roam around free.
By the age of 15, one in five women have experienced stalking, 75% by someone they know. The true figures likely far higher. Less than half of stalking incidents are reported to police. Unlike most victims of stalking, Di and Celeste did report their stalkers. And just like Di, Celeste had an intervention order to keep her stalker away. But it wasn't enough.
All victims of murder should have justice served with life. Do you agree?
Yeah.
We heard Celeste's mum, Aggie, there, and she's with us now. Aggie, plenty of people marching alongside you today. What does it mean to you and your family?
Getting community support means everything. We actually hoped there would have been many, many more people, Hamish. We didn't march today because that was to beg last time. Today was insisting on an appeal. Today was about highlighting what doesn't make sense about this sentence, and none of it makes sense. Today was about highlighting the fact that one judge's discretion can fall short of getting any justice when I know that there's a couple of other judges that would have given a life sentence here.
Well, Seiko was handed a 36-year sentence for taking your daughter's life. Why is it important to you that it is more than that?
It's based on principle. The non-parole period is still the same. This is based on principle. We are told by the courts that they uphold the human sanctity of life. We are told that all of their decisions are with community expectations in mind, and we are told that all of their decisions are in the interest of justice. I don't see how this is in the interest of justice. This was the premeditated murder of a young 23-year-old girl. She had plans like everybody else. It was evil, it was brutal, it was because we didn't drop an intervention order, it was payback. And the courts have just sent a very clear message to anyone else who doesn't drop an intervention order.
What happens if you don't get an appeal?
I'm going to keep insisting for an appeal. I mean, we've got a change.org petition that's linked three petitions in Celeste's name. There's just under 54,000 signatures on there. I would like to believe that if people are signing, whether it's for the appeal, whether it's for stringent stalking laws, whether it's for mandatory life sentences, it does not matter. They want change.
As you make the point, this was premeditated, and often in those sorts of circumstances, the perpetrator will try to find any way around whatever laws and provisions are in place. Do you still think that this could have been prevented?
Absolutely. And that's the other thing. You know, we've got community members telling me to keep fighting, to keep changing the stalking laws. Great to have their children protected, their loved ones protected. I don't get to protect Celeste anymore. To me, had this beast had an ankle bracelet on him, we would have had at least an opportunity to get the hell out of the house that night.
36 years for the death of your beautiful daughter, 30 years before Seiko is eligible for parole. Do you ever let your mind go to the place where Seiko is out, back on the streets?
No, never. I don't really think he'll survive it. But I want him to suffer for a very, very long time. My insistence on an appeal is purely based on principle. We cannot continue to show mercy to people who willfully take another person's life. She had done nothing to him, just asked him to please leave her alone. It makes no sense to me, with the comparable sentences they used, that Eurisi Dixon, thank God, got justice through a life sentence. That was the prosecution's comparable sentence, and yet Celeste was not deserving of the same kind of justice. With a more premeditated murder, brutal, in our home, she was not even walking home at night.
Aggie Di Mauro, really appreciate you talking to us tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you.